Good afternoon, class. Today I will be teaching about the care of patients with skin surgery. So this class is basically for BSc second year med surgery. So we all know. So I have taught you about the surgeries. Okay, the different type of skin surgery that is being performed on a patient for the various skin disease condition. So based on that, now you will see about the care. Okay, what are the roles and responsibilities of a nurse regarding the surgery? Okay, so this surgery can be like a plastic surgery, or it can be any facial reconstructive surgery, or a flap surgery, or any hair treatment, or hair transplant, or any other surgery management, surgical management for disease condition. So according to the Association of Perioperative Registered Nurses, okay, recommended practices committee described the goals of preoperative skin preparation. So before the surgery, we will be emphasizing on the preoperative care. Okay, so what are the goals of the preoperative skin preparation? And they are as follows. Number one, the removal of soil and transient microbes from the skin. So that is one of the important points, that is you have to remove any microbes or any infection from the skin. Okay, suppose the skin is moist, or it is dirty, okay, it is filled with mud, or it is filled with blood, then we have to clean the skin properly, the skin surface, okay, with an antiseptic, and we have to make the skin ready for the surgery. Next, the rapid reduction of resident microbes without tissue irritation. Okay, so the purpose for removing this microbe is to reduce the presence of microbes without any tissue irritation. Meaning, if the patient is the nurse is using any antiseptic solution like Betadine. Okay, for cleaning the skin surface, we have to make sure that the patient is not having any allergies to the Betadine solution. Okay, so you have to make sure that there is no tissue irritation, that there is no skin allergies to that specific antiseptic solution. So some patients are allergic to Betadine, some patients are allergic to Dettol in antiseptic, or they are allergic to any alcohol rub. So we have to make sure that we have to ask and we have to assess the patient before applying any of these antiseptic solution for cleaning the skin. So the inhibition of rapid rebound growth of these microbes. So the main important reason for removing the soil and the transient microbe from the skin is to stop the growth of these microbes or these microorganisms, and to stop the rapid and rebound growth of these microorganisms, so that the microorganisms will not grow on the skin surface. Okay, so the skin surface should be clear from any microorganism. So then for the patient with a planned procedure, skin preparation begins at home. Patient education is very essential. Okay, so if the doctor has planned for any plastic surgery, for example. Okay, so suppose the doctor is saying that tomorrow is a plastic surgery. Okay, so what happens is the patient has to begin the skin preparation one day before the surgery. And therefore, the nurse should give important education to the patient on how to maintain the skin. Okay, how to, remove the hairs from the skin and all that. So that is very important. So the for patients undergoing class 1, that is clean procedures below the chin, the Registered Nursing Association recommended that 2 showers by using chlorhexidine glucolate before surgery is recommended. Why? To decrease the number of microorganisms on the skin. So therefore, shower or taking bath with chlorhexidine glucolate is necessary before the surgery. Okay. Next, although the act of showering or bathing with regular soap will reduce the skin flora, but using 4% of chlorhexidine gluconate, it will double the reduction. Therefore, we can tell the patient to use salt, but this chlorhexidine 4% solution, it is more powerful than soap in reducing the microorganism from the skin, and it will prepare the skin for the surgery. So the CDC also supports the patient showering or taking bath with an antiseptic agent at least on the night before surgery. So like I said, that one day before the surgery, the patient has to make sure that the skin that the patient should take bath and make sure that the skin hygiene is maintained. Okay, and taking bath not with soap but with 4% chlorhexidine gluconate solution. Okay, why? Because this reduces the microorganisms from the skin. So important teaching points including achieving a contact time of 2 minutes and thorough rinsing to remove residual chlorhexidine, which can cause skin irritation, is followed by drying with a clean towel. So we have to tell the patient that after taking bath with, by using chlorhexidine solution, okay, then after showering, then we can clean or we can dry the skin by using a clean towel. So we have to make sure that a clean towel is being used for drying the skin. And the patient should not apply any powder or lotion after the shower or after taking bath. After taking bath with chlorhexidine gluconate solution, the patient should not use any powder or should not use any cream lotion or should not use any other perfume. Okay, and should wear fresh clothes and not the same clothes. So these are some of the important points that we have to make sure for preoperative skin preparation. Next, when the patient arrives for the surgery, confirm that he or she has taken the preoperative shower as instructed. So before the surgery, you have to ask the patient whether he or she has taken bath with chlorhexidine gluconate solution and whether he or she is taking precautions. And if the patient has not performed, then we will wash the surgical site in the preoperative area according to the procedure. So if patient is not able to, wash or taking bath with chlorhexidine solution, then in the OT, okay, there is a pre-operative area. So what happens is the nurse will perform the skin preparation in that area, that is called the pre-operative area. So the nurse will clean the surface of the skin, the surgical site of the patient with chlorhexidine gluconate solution. The days of shaving hair from the operative site with a razor before surgery are long gone. Okay, advise the patient not to shave the operative site before arriving for the surgery. So we have to advise the patient not to shave. Okay, so whatever the surgical site area is, we have to tell the patient not to shave before arriving, meaning that like 1-2 days before the surgery, during that period, the patient has to shave the skin area. Then try to keep hair out of the way for surgery on the head. Try creative strategies like braiding or non-inflammable hair gel. Okay, so in case of hair transplantation, okay, so we can use, the remaining hair can be braided or non-inflammable hair gel. Okay, hair gel can be used to prevent obstruction of hair while performing the surgery. Next, the final stage in skin preparation is to apply an antiseptic to the site. Okay, so in every surgical management, the doctor before doing any surgery, he will always use an antiseptic solution on the site of the surgery. Next, what are the duties of plastic surgery nurse? Okay, so there are nurses which are specified for such surgeries like plastic surgery. Okay, so they have some specific duties, or we can say special duties that they have to perform. Okay, the plastic surgery nurses, they work alongside the surgeons and they support the staff to assist the patient in achieving their desired results. So here the plastic surgery nurses, they work together with the surgeons and they have some specific duties like screening the patient for surgery. Okay, checking if if the surgical site has been washed, has been cleaned properly with antiseptic solutions, or make sure that there is no hair on the surgical site. Okay. Next duty is reviewing the medical and surgical history. So we have to, nurse should ask for the present medical history, past medical history, present surgical history, past surgical history, then the allergic histories, any allergies to any specific food or any specific lotion or cream or any solution, then administering treatments such as chemical peels, Botox or light and laser treatment. So these also, she has some specific duties. Okay, she can perform like chemical peel while providing Botox or providing any light and laser treatment. Next, preparing the procedure or operating room. So it is a responsibility for preparing the OT where the surgery is to be performed. Monitor the patients during and after procedure. So pre-operative procedures and post-operative care should be given to the patient. Next, educating the patient on specific procedures and what to expect before, during and after. So education about the surgical management. Okay. What to expect before, okay, during the surgery, what are the steps, or what will happen during the surgery, and what will happen after the surgery, what are the prognosis, and what are the positive outcome or the negative outcome, all these have to be explained to the patient. Next, the following up of with patients after the procedures to ensure healing. So follow-up is very important. You have to educate that follow-up with the doctors and the nurses also are very important for progressive healing. And last is wound care and surgical site care. So wound care and surgical site care should be explained to the patient, okay, before discharge from the hospital. How to maintain skin care, how to maintain skin hygiene, okay. No excessive pressure on the incision site, or no applying of any perfume or any lotion or chemicals on their face after the surgery. So all these should be education about all these should be given to the patient. Next, roles of plastic surgery nurse. So plastic surgery nurse have a multitude of duties and roles as they are involved with patients before. So these nurses are involved with the patients. They are there with the patients before the surgery. They are there with the patients during the surgery and also after the surgery. So they are responsible for collaborating with physicians regarding possible barriers to the surgery. So they have to collaborate. Okay, they have to have a good rapport with the physicians. Next, educating patients and families on post-op expectations and healing. Next, providing support to the patient and families while promoting a positive self-image. Okay, so psychological support should be given to the patient and also to the family about the, and also we have to promote positive self-image. Okay, we should not demotivate the patient, but we should always keep the spirit high. Okay, always motivate them regarding the self-image or the body image. Next, provide a sensitive, non-biased, non-judgmental environment for patients undergoing cosmetic procedure. So we should not be biased, we should not be judgmental, okay, regarding the patient's surgery and their disease condition. Then remaining up to date with current cosmetic surgery, standards of care and practice. So the nurse should be up to date. What are the new technologies? What are the new medications? Or what are the new techniques for any surgical management or cosmetic surgery, okay, in terms of care and practice. Then she should be up to date. Next, she should ensure a safe and aseptic environment to avoid post-op infection and complications. So sterile dressings, okay, sterile procedures should be maintained. Sterility should be maintained in the OT and also in the post-op room or the post-op ward, to prevent any or to avoid any infection or complications. Next, working with the entire care team to ensure the physical, mental, and psychosocial needs are met. So, not only among the nurses, but they should work together with the doctors, with the housekeeping staff, with the lab technicians, okay, and with the with the anesthetist, with everyone. There should be a good interpersonal relationship, and they should collaborate with their work. They should have a good teamwork amongst all of them. So that is the role of a plastic surgery nurse. So these are some of the cares and the roles and responsibilities of a nurse, okay, while taking care of a patient with skin surgery. Okay, so I hope you have understood. We have come to the end of the topic today.